Thank you for the introduction and for the opportunity to present on our work, on our project on the quality of life in desmoid tripanosomiasis, and specifically the development of a disease-specific quality of life questionnaire. Well, short introduction, but I think it's all familiar for you, but desmoid tripanosomiasis, which I will now call DTF for the during my presentation. Well, it is an uncommon soft tissue tumor, and although it does not metastasize, it can cause significant morbidity by its local invasive growth, and it's therefore classified as an intermediate tumor. It has a variable clinical course, which makes the choice of an appropriate treatment option challenging. As Bernd Kasper already told, the most recent European consensus guideline advocates active surveillance as primary treatment for asymptomatic and mildly symptomatic patients, and in case of persistent progression or increase in symptoms, a change from surveillance to active treatment can be considered. But unfortunately, these active forms of treatment, including surgical resection or systemic therapies, do not always guarantee tumor reduction or clinical benefit, and surgical resection has high recurrence rates, or there are side effects from the systemic treatments. So there are a lot of symptoms. Symptoms vary depending on the tumor site, the size. The tumor could result in pain or functional impairment, but there could also be side effects from certain treatments. But apart from the physical symptoms, previous studies show that patients also struggle with other difficulties. For example, a delayed diagnosis due to the rarity of the disease, or financial difficulties or changes in psychosocial functioning. And altogether, we think that assessment of the health-related quality of life would help to evaluate treatment efficacy, and the consequences of the treatment, and maybe could help to guide treatment decision making. So health-related quality of life, well, the last decade, the emphasis on this has increased substantially, and most of the times health-related quality of life is assessed using the more generic questionnaires, such as the IORTC, for example. And this questionnaire measures the impact of the disease on physical domains, with questions as, during the last week, were you tired? Or do you have any trouble walking a long walk? And these questions can be completed by every patient with all kinds of diseases or other cancer types. And also the general population could answer these questions. But these questions could contain items that might be irrelevant for DGF patients. And by only using the more generic questionnaires, we still don't have any insight in the specific issues DTF patients experience. Currently, only one DTF specific tool is available, the GARDAS, which is developed by the in the United States with the help of the DTRF. And the development of this questionnaire enhanced our possibilities to assess the DTF related quality of life, but this one cannot be used in addition to the IORTC QLQC30. And that's why we have chosen in Europe to develop a DTF specific health related quality of life tool that can be accompanied by the IORTC QLQC30, which allows us to make a comparison with the quality of life of patients with other type of diseases, as well as the general population. And the development of this questionnaire was one of the goals of the qualified study, which is an international multicenter cross-sectional study where DTF patients answered a lot of questionnaires. And one of the aims was to develop and pretest the DTF specific health-related quality of life tool. So how did we do it previously? A systematic literature review was conducted, and focus groups and interviews were organized in the United Kingdom and the Netherlands. And additionally, 124 issues were ranked according to their relevance by patients and healthcare providers. And these studies identified issues covering various domains, including the diagnostic pathway, the treatment pathway, daily limitations, and the experiences with the current health system. And based on the results of these studies, the most relevant issues were operationalized into 102 questions to design a DTF-specific health-related quality of life tool, which was named the DTF-QOL. And this questionnaire was pre-tested in a group of 236 DTF patients. And after analysis of their answers, we developed 14 different subscales. And a subscale contains a group of questions that are all associated with a specific concept. I will show you the scales we developed. The first three subscales contain questions with a time frame during last week. So we consider these skills the more symptom-related subscales because they have a short time frame, because they are all asking for problems or symptoms which were present during the last week. And we named these subscales the emotional and psychological consequences, physical consequences, and pain and discomfort. And for example, the pain and discomfort subscale contains a question: during the past week, have you been unable to lean on the tuber side? The other 11 subscales contain questions with a time frame since your diagnosis. So we consider these the items in these subscales the more the disease impact skills, and we named the skills worries and concerns, a job and education, doctor-patient relationship, communication and information, understanding and support by others, physical burden and related limitations, diagnostic and treatment trajectory of DTF, parents and fertility, body image and sensation, supportive care, concerns around treatment and its consequences, and the unpredictable clinical course and nature of DTF. And for example, the last subscale contains a question: since your diagnosis, have you felt frustrated about the benign diagnosis with cancerous futures? So the mean scores of all these subscales can be used to look at differences between specific groups. So for example, between males or females, or between different ages. And in our next project, we are going to look into these group differences. But for now, we already explored some groups. So these are preliminary results. So first, we looked at age, and then we compared the patients' age between 18 and 39 years, and patients older than 40. And what you see here is the mean scores on all the subscales. You can score between 0 and 100, and a higher score indicates more problems or more symptoms. So when we compared these two groups, we saw that the younger patients had a significantly higher score in the subscale with questions concerning understanding and support by others, the parents and fertility subscale, body image and sensation, concerns around treatment and its consequences, and the unpredictable clinical course and nature of DTF. We also compared males and female patients, we found significant differences on the same subscales I just showed before in the age group. And here we found that the female patients scored higher on the understanding and support by others, parents and fertility, body image and sensation. And then in the concerns around treatment and its consequences, we found that the male patients scored higher, and the unpredictable clinical course, the female patients scored a little bit higher. We also compared patients who received only wait and see or active surveillance treatment to patients who received any kind of active treatment. So this could contain surgical resection, systemic therapies, or a combination of all. As you see, a lot of information on one slide, because we found that a lot of subscales were different between the group with only wait and see and the active treatment group. What is striking now is that we found significant differences in the more symptom-related scales. As I told previously, we had three subscales who looked more into the symptom-related questions, and those were these three. And we see for the symptom-related scales that people with any form of active treatment score higher on the emotional and psychological consequences, physical consequences, and pain and discomfort. And next to the more symptom-related scales, we also have the more disease impact scales. And we found some of the scales, as I already showed, but you also see that on the worries and concerns subscale, the job and education subscale, the understanding and support by others, physical burden and the related limitations, the diagnostic and treatment trajectory of DTF, the concerns around the treatment and the unpredictable clinical course. For all of those skills, people with an active form of treatment scored higher. So what we can see is because you can conclude that an form of active treatment could, this could indicate that this has a severe impact on quality of life in different domains. And finally, for this preliminary analysis, we also compared patients with recurrent disease, here depicted in orange, with patients who don't have any recurrent disease. And we found that the patients with recurrent disease scored higher on all of the subscales. So that indicates more symptoms or more problems. And we found that they scored higher on one of the symptom scales, the physical consequences. And they scored also higher on the worries and concerns, job and education, physical burden, also the parents and fertility subscale, body image and sensation, the concerns about the treatment and the unpredictable course and nature of DTF. So the next step of this project will be to further evaluate these group differences. This was just explorative, so we can show this to you today. But with this result, we hope to identify risk factors for patients at risk for a poor quality of life. And if we have this clear, you can say that you can use a certain subscale for a specific group of patients to get more insight in their quality of life. But you can also say that you use a subscale for a specific type of research. And furthermore, the more symptom-related skills, so with the time frame during the past week, could be used in clinical trials, whereas the other, the impact of the disease items could potentially be used during the follow-up of patients in their treating hospital. So in conclusion, we developed a DTF-specific health-related quality of life questionnaire, which consists of 95 questions and 14 subscales. And this DTF QOL can be used alongside the EORTC QOQ-C30. And the future use of this questionnaire will help to gain more insight into the prevalence of the specific health-related quality of life issues, which could truly help to provide personalized care. And integration of this questionnaire into the clinical practice and research combined with the more traditional measures, such as the progression-free survival, will provide a more comprehensive assessment of the overall management of these DTF patients. And with that, I would like to thank all collaborators on this project, and I would like to thank you for your attention. And I am happy to answer any questions.